Some interesting news from Congo are arriving. So, on January 24th, the new leader, Felix Tshisekedi, was sworn in, and it was the first time in the Republic's life that power was transferred from one party to another in a peaceful way. But the media had spun a narrative according to which Foyulu had been the official opposition leader and was made out to be some kind of revolutionary hero, while the reality is that Feyulu was an ex-ExxonMobil executive and was friends with warlords and supported by warlords. And the major question in these elections from a business perspective was if the taxes that were instituted under former leader Kaliba's reign on cobalt and on coltan would be repealed or would be further instituted. And Tshisekedi has not made any public announcements before the elections, but now he has declared that he will not repeal the taxes, that he will keep the taxes. And I think this is really good news because Congo has never seen much prosperity from the rich resources which are underneath it. The majority of coltan is mined in Congo, and the conditions under which it is mined are disastrous. And I think it's great to see that some of the wealth that is produced there stays within the country. Of course, business lobbyists have made a good amount of pressure in order to get those taxes repealed, but Tshisekedi seems to be able to withstand this pressure and to keep them. Furthermore, Tshisekedi has promised to release incarcerated opposition leaders and to rescind the declared exiles on some other opposition leaders. Of course, it is not clear if he will keep those promises, but at least the fact that he doesn't repeal those taxes, I think, is a good sign. Meanwhile, Fayulu has immediately declared himself the real president and declared election fraud, and has already taken steps to provoke a civil war, which would be disastrous for the country. And I think the most important priority right now is to make sure the country does not drift into a new civil war, because Congo has been ravaged by a lot of civil wars in the past, and it has never been pretty. But overall, these are not too bad news. I want you to subscribe and click the bell. Also, I want your questions and your feedback. You can send them to me by Facebook, by Twitter, and by email. The links are below. Thank you for your time.